Okay, today we're gonna benchmark the 3080 and the 99LFA and see how it performs like.
We are losing objective Charlie.
Yeah. We're gonna lower the sound a little bit and we're gonna move to video. So basically everything is ultra. We're seeing with DirectX 12. Resolution scale is like 100% and it's 19. It's basically 1080p. So let's see how it performs like and what we can expect here. So as you can see, the usage on my GPU is 60-50%, which basically means that we are heavily CPU bound. But that's to be expected when you hit like 200 frames, really. Oh shit. So in short, this is perfectly playable. I think I already got the frame cap. With my 1080 Ti, which could be the card is a lot faster though on rasterization. There's no DLSS of DirectX, or what is it, or ray tracing, so we don't have to account for that. But yeah, in general, like, perfectly smooth, probably always stays above 140 fps.
We have taken objective.
So perfectly fine. Let's move the resolution up. So video, we're gonna now move to, here we go, 1440p, let's apply it. Yep. Okay, let's see what we got there. The GPU usage is about 60%. Oh god, I'm dead. I hear him. He's in there. So basically it's about, well, still 140 FPS. It makes sense because look at the taxation of the GPU. It's a bit higher, but it's still not getting maxed out. So I'm kind of curious what it's going to do with 4K. Let's test it out. Video, let's move to 4K. Yep, let's apply. Here we go. Okay, so this is 4K. My hard drive, the little spikes come from my hard drive because the game isn't completely preloaded 100% yet, which results in having a little bit of micro stutter sometimes. This fucker go away. Holy shit. One more. Can't see him. Well, that worked. Oh, there he is. Dude, I think I got the whole squadron down there. Holy shit. I think I saw like a chiropter. No. It's a door. Oh, there he is. Ah, too bad. Yeah, in general, now it's actually sits at 100% usage, so it's good to see. 200 FPS is limiter, yeah, but you need a CPU that can push it. I'm not sure if there's any CPU in the market that can actually hit it stable. So, yeah. We because here we are still CPU bottlenecked, even with even on 4K. So I'm kind of curious. I'm not sure if we can DSR to 8K. Should actually research that. But I would assume this game is perfectly fine playable at 8K. Funny enough, yeah, the game just doesn't require much. Battlefield 5 is a little bit more demanding. Like 30-40 FPS more demanding, I would say. So, yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. And yeah, this is pretty much how Battlefield 1 performs on a 3080-9900K. I think the only one that I have left is Red Dead Redemption 2. That is tough to do, but it's tough to buy the game first, so I'm waiting a little bit of a discount. That's the only one I still want to benchmark, and everything else, like, I benchmarked up to I think 50 plus games at this point. I think that's a good solution for now. New games come out, we'll benchmark them, etc., etc. But yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching, and later, guys.